Hello, and in this video, I'm going to show how to set up the UART in asynchronous 8-bit mode. First, the hardware connections. I have the pins connected to RC6 and RC7 to a FTDI USB serial converter, with the RX connected to RC6, which is the TX of the PIC, and the TX connected to RC7 of the PIC, which is the receive line. Now, first we go to the datasheet. Now, the UART is controlled by three registers: the TXstat register, RCA register, and the Baudcon register. First thing is the TRC7 and TRC6 bits must be equal to 1, which sets them to input, and the SPIN in RC and receive status register must be set to 1. The first register we're going to go through is the transmission status and control register, or for short, TXstat. Since we're going to set up in asynchronous mode, bit 7 is irrelevant, and we're using 8-bit mode, so bit 6 is irrelevant. Bit 5 TXN enables the TX pin on the PIC, which is the transmit enable bit. Then we have bit 4, which is the mode select. Either we're going to go into synchronous or asynchronous mode, and in this case, we're using asynchronous mode. Bit 3 is irrelevant, the send break character. And then the BRGH register on bit 2 is, are we using high baud rate or low baud rate? And then the transmit shift register bit, which detects if the TX buffer has been written to or is empty currently. And then TX9D is irrelevant since we're using 8-bit. Then we have our receive status and control register, which contains in bit 7 SPIN, which is used to enable the serial port. And this automatically sets up the RX and TX pins on RC6 and RC7. Bit 6 is irrelevant. SREN is also irrelevant. Then we have CREN, which is the continuous receive. This is so the port constantly listens for a transmission from another device. So we are going to have that enabled. Bit 3 is irrelevant. And then we have our framing error bit and our overrun bit in bit 1 and 2. This will only be for some light error handling when we receive data from the FTDI to the PIC. And then bit 0 is irrelevant again. Then we have our Baudcon register, and the only bit we are interested in here is bit 3, which is the 16-bit baud rate register enable. This just tells if we're using the baud rate generator high byte, referred to as SBBRGH. Otherwise, we're only using SBBRG. Let's get to coding. Now, just to run over what is currently enabled and disabled. I'm using stdint to have easier macros for my data type, and then stdbool so I can use booleans. Then we have the forward declaration of the high priority and low priority interrupt. Then we have the main, which we set the oscillator to 8 MHz. You can have a look at my previous video where I do the oscillator configs. And then we enable the interrupts so that we have priorities and our global interrupt enables. This is also from a previous video. And then we have our infinite loop. Then we just have our high and low interrupt functions. First, we start with a function void uart underscore init, and we're going to pass a value of unsigned int 16. Call it gen reg. Then we have an unsigned called sync. We have another unsigned called brgh. Last, we have an unsigned called brg16. Now, in the function, we start with setting TRC7 and 6 as inputs. So, TRC bits dot RC7 equals 1. Copy this line. And then RC6 also equal to 1. Then we quickly refer back to the datasheet. We come down to the associated register. Now in the associated register, we have SPBRGH and SPBRG. These two values are used to generate the clock for the UART. Now back to the code. We first set SPBRGH equals to bracket genreg and mask it with 0xFF00. Then we shift a bit right by 8. Then we have SPBRG equal to genreg and mask it with 00FFhex. Then we enable the receiver by writing to RCSTA bits.cren equals 1. Copy this line. And then receive status bits spen is also equal to 1. So this is the serial port enable. Then we set the BaudCon register bit. So we go BaudCon bits dot BRG16 equals to BRG16. Then we start with the transmit status control register, which is TXSTA bits dot sync equals sync. Then we copy this line again. We change the member to BRGH equals BRGH. And then we paste again. We say TXEN equals 1. Now we're going to enable the interrupts for the receive. So we refer back to the datasheet. Now in the associated registers in table 18.6, we have the peripheral interrupt request 1 register, which contains our receive interrupt flag. Then we have our peripheral interrupt enable register 1. We have our receive interrupt enable. And then in the interrupt priority register 1, we have the receive interrupt priority bit. So now back to the code. So first we set the priority of the interrupt with IPR 1 bits RCIP equals 1 to make it a high priority interrupt. Then we set PIE 1 bits dot RCEIE equals to 1 to enable the interrupt. And then lastly, we set the transmit interrupt, which you refer back to the datasheet. Then in the associated registers in table 18.5, the peripheral interrupt request 1 register has the TXIF bit located in it. And then in the peripheral interrupt enable 1 register, we have the TX interrupt enable. And then in IPR1, we have TXIP enable. Now back to the code. We copy the line IPR1 bits, change the member to TX interrupt priority equals 0 to make it a low priority interrupt. PIE 1 bits, member TXIE is equals to 1 to enable the interrupt. Then we run down to our interrupt service routines. Then in our low priority interrupt, we test PIR1 bits dot PXI1. So we test if the specific interrupt has triggered. Then we copy this line, paste it to our high priority interrupts, and then we test in our high priority interrupts if PIR1 bits RCIF has been triggered. So this is when we receive a byte from the UART. Then we set a function to do a send via the UART. So this will be void UART send, then we pass a pointer of unsigned 8 bits, call it pointer C, then we say TX reg is equals to the value of C. Then we wait until the TX buffer is empty, which is done by while TX STA bits dot TRMT is equivalent to zero. So what this line does is just wait for TX reg to become empty. Now, after our functions are done, we make a global variable of size unsigned 8 bits. We'll call it data and equals to character capital A. Let's correct this void. Then in our main loop, we create a delay with underscore delay ms 200 milliseconds. And we say UART send is referenced to data. Okay, now that the base code has been set up, we start with the initialization of the UART. So we copy the function name. We place it just after our oscillator has stabilized. Now the first value we want to set is the baud rate generator value. Now we refer back to the datasheet. Now under section 18.1, we have the baud rate generator. Now we have all sorts of tables that we can use to calculate our baud rate width. And then we have also the exact formula we can calculate the baud rate with and the error rate of the baud rate. But nice thing about this PIC is it has a cheat sheet to calculate the baud rates. So we scroll down and we have the baud rate tables for each baud rate with the oscillator frequency. Now I'm going to set this up as 9.6 kilobits per second. So we go down and we see what our sync settings, our BRGH settings should be, and our BRG16 settings should be for an 8 MHz clock frequency. Our SPGR register needs a value of 51 decimal. So back to the code, we add 51 decimal. Now I've ordered the function name to be easily read from the datasheet. Now we refer back. Our sync BRGH and BRG16 should be equal to 010. So back to the code, we add to our init function 010. And this will initialize the UART. Now we program the PIC. Now while we wait, I'll quickly open my PuTTY console. Now apparently it doesn't work. Okay, so I've found and squished the cockroach in the bug. So what happened is, for some reason, if you enable the TX interrupts, TXR transmit bit never goes to zero. So what I'm suspecting is you have to write to it in the interrupt routine. I also added the interrupt flag clears to the interrupt service routines. So now shown by PuTTY, we're continuously sending over 8 characters to the computer via the UART. The next thing I'm going to code is a loopback test. First, what we need is to write the receive function for the UART. So we start with void UART receiver. Check that I spelled that correctly. And we pass a pointer of unsigned 8 bits. We'll call that C. And we pass a pointer to a boolean, and we'll call it RX flag. Now we do some simple error handling. First we refer to the datasheet. Now in the receive status and control register, we first check for a framing error, and then we check for an overrun error. Now the framing error can be cleared by reading the RC reg, which contains the data received from the RX line. The overrun error can be done by clearing and setting CREN bit. Now back to the code. First we check for framing error, which is if rc stat bits dot FERR is true, then we just read the RCREG. So we declare a variable of unsigned 8 bits, and we'll call it ER equals RCREG. Else, if we have a overrun error, we check RCStatBits dot overrun error is true. We set RCStatBits dot CREN equals to 0, and then we set CREN equals back to 1. And then finally, we have an else. We just read the data from the RCREG to the pointer data, and we set the RX flag. Flag equals true. We declare a global boolean, and we'll call it got data underscore bool equals false. Now we copy our UART receive function and we paste it in to our high priority interrupt in the receive flag test. We reference it to data and then we reference it to the got data boolean. Now in our main loop, we remove the UART send and the delay, and we say if got data bool is true, then we send whatever is in the data variable, and we set our gotDataBool to false. Now we program the PIC. Now what is your problem? Illegal conversion of pointer to integer. I got a pointer. Now we try and program again. This must be C. And then we have RX flag. We bold again. Now we program the PIC. We go to our PuTTY terminal, we reset the terminal. Ever I type on the keyboard will now be looped back from the PIC to the PC. And that's a basic introduction to how to use the UART on a PIC. Any code that I have written will be linked on my Git. Any parts that I have used will be linked down in the description. A like, share, comment, and subscription would be greatly appreciated. Thank you. Have a nice day.